Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the Queen of the Ring podcast. So this looks a little different. This may sound a little bit different if you're listening to the audio form of this podcast episode. I did record an episode with Nick Tulo, Tiptoe with Tulo, and he was a last minute guest. Things were happening. I have been in deep preparation for WrestleMania weekend. We are 2 weeks away from WrestleMania, and I've got some really good content planned, and I've just been planning it. And I am a normal human being outside of being a content creator and having multiple things on my plate is a lot. So forgive me if this isn't the podcast episode that you were expecting today. Obviously, I am not going to do shoot or boot since I do not have a co-host for this episode. However, I am going to be talking about the week in wrestling, a brief little week in wrestling. I do need to go over AEW Dynamite last night. It was probably one of the best Dynamites I've seen in a bit. The opening segment with MJF and his bar mitzvah, having the pillars of AEW, which was Darby Allin, Jungle Boy, and Sammy Guevara coming out, challenging MJF for the title, I thought was really good stuff. I really, really enjoyed this Dynamite. Taya Valkyrie coming out, challenging Jade Cargill. I think that's going to be a fantastic feud. I think that's the feud that Jade Cargill needs, possibly to maybe light a fire under her reign right now. I really wish something would have happened with Jade Cargill and Red Velvet, because I think that Red Velvet would have been the perfect person to take away the title from Jade Cargill. And, you know, there seems like it would have been a good story to tell. But we're going to get Taya Valkyrie. And I think Taya Valkyrie is a great addition to AEW. So really excited to see what she will bring to the women's roster. And speaking of the women's roster, I'm pretty sure we're hinting at a blood and guts with the women when it comes to the Outcasts, which is Saraya, Ruby Soho, and Toni Storm, picking at Jamie Hayter, Britt Baker. We also had Rio, Willow Nightingale, and Sky Blue helping them out as well. So I think we're hinting at it. Looking forward to seeing who else would be joining the Outcasts. So it'll be good. It'll be a good buildup. I honestly kind of hope it's the Garcia twins so that AEW fans can be mad eternally. I do have to go over that one segment. I will get to it in a bit with the Bella twins switching their names to the Garcia twins. However, the main event for Dynamite, which was Kenny Omega teaming up with the Young Bucks, the Elite versus the House of Black versus the Jericho Appreciation Society for the Trios Championship. And man, that boy Kenny Omega, what a beautiful, beautiful wrestler. He is so good. He is so good. What a great wrestler. Man, I feel like he really was in his element last night when, you know, they were in Winnipeg. I think that was the first time he's been back at Winnipeg in a long time. I can't recall the last time he wrestled in Winnipeg, but you also had Chris Jericho there as well, another Winnipeg Ian. I don't know what you call Winnipeg people, but it was awesome to see, man. And the crowd was so hot throughout the whole entire show. And I think this is what AEW needed, right? I think that AEW wasn't served the right, like AEW didn't have a chance to really branch out internationally, right? Before the lockdown in 2020, the company only was in for like 6 months. 6 months they were in this brand new company, AEW, and they didn't have a chance to branch out internationally, which, you know, is a blow when you are a new company. But they're making up for lost time for sure. AEW is going to be in the UK this year. And they just announced that they are going to have a string of Canadian shows this summer. So shout out to all the Canadians who are AEW fans, massive AEW fans at that, because you guys are eating well this summer. And that also includes the Forbidden Door pay-per-view. It is going to be in Toronto, and again, you guys are gonna eat very well. Very happy for you folks up there in Canada. But man, I really feel like that you know, je ne sais quoi that Kenny had back in New Japan was back last night. And he is just, he's a machine. He's a wrestling machine. I absolutely love him. I absolutely adore him. Really happy that House of Black retained, and really looking forward to seeing what is in the future for House of Black. I think they are on a good streak right now. So really looking forward to it. But I didn't get into a lot of things about AEW, but definitely recommend watching this week's Dynamite because it was fantastic. Now, let's move on to probably the most controversial thing that was happening on the internet right now in the wrestling IWC, which was the Bella Twins. The Bella Twins decided they are no more Bella Twins, and they will be referred to as the Garcia Twins. Their contract is up with WWE. They are no longer with WWE anymore, and they are the Garcia Twins. I'm sure because of, you know, trademarking and all that jazz, they couldn't keep the Bella Twins. And I think that this is probably the best for them, right? You know, like they've always said, especially since the Total Divas days, they've always said that they wanted to focus on their careers outside of the ring, and they wanted to focus on their families as well. A lot of people got upset, and a lot of people jumped the gun, as wrestling fans do, and assumed that they were going to go into AEW, especially since they were seen at AEW Revolution. And for some reason, that doesn't compute to people's heads that maybe they were just backstage to visit friends. And, you know, Brie Garcia is married to an AEW wrestler, which is Bryan Danielson. So, of course, once in a while, you're going to see them backstage. If they did go to AEW, it would be great for the women's division. You know, like, I think a lot of fans discredit the Garcia Twins. I'll refer to them as the Bella Twins for the sake of this conversation right now. But I think that there are so many people that discredit the Bella Twins simply because they have conquered and they were successful in WWE without being hardcore wrestling fans, without being the wrestlers that grew up with wrestling. And I know that's a hard pill to swallow for some wrestling fans, but that's okay. You know, they gave so much respect to the business. And, you know, I know a lot of people want to bring up Nikki Bella not remembering that Vader passed away. But listen, man, like, they got a lot of things on their plate. They are entrepreneurs. They have vineyards. They have a clothing line now. They have a production, I think. Possibly, if they don't, they're possibly in the running for that. They have so many, 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 many different projects happening outside of WWE and families, you know? And it's one of those things that people can't process. What some people, majority of men in wrestling, can't process the fact that something in wrestling was not catered to them. Because let's face it, I've said this before on my episode with Reggie, with Righteous Reg, they were not going to tune in to watch E! Entertainment Network anyway. So they were definitely not going to do it with Total Divas. And Total Divas lasted for 9 years, nine seasons. That's pretty successful, you know? And the Bella Twins, the Garcia Twins, are without a doubt, I would say, the top 10 most successful superstars that conquered the outside bubble of wrestling, of sports entertainment. I would put them up there with Batista. I would put them up there with The Rock. I mean, they're not in the level of The Rock. Like I said, they're top 10. I think number one would be The Rock. but they are in the top 10 most successful superstars that are outside, you know, outside of WWE. And I think that just there's some people that just don't want to accept that and want to respect that. And that's okay, you know. And I think a lot of people are on the fence of, oh, well, they're not the best wrestler, I don't get them. It's like, it's not for you to get. And they're not going to be Bret Hart level wrestling, you know, like they're just not. Are there other women that are now in the company, outside of the company, during their time in the company that were better wrestlers than them? Yeah, there are. And listen, I'm not a huge Bella's Twins fan. I mean, growing up, I mean, not really growing up because I'm 31, but getting back into wrestling and the Bella Twins were on TV, I was just like, okay, you know, they're all right. They're really not for me, but they're all right. And it wasn't until I watched Total Divas where I was like, holy shit, like these women care about wrestling. And although they are not presented as individuals that appreciate wrestling and respect wrestling, you know, they're glitz and glam, and there's nothing wrong with that. They you know, are the definition of divas, and they did conquer, and they're Hall of Famers now. And a lot of people are upset about that, but I just think that a lot of people just don't want to accept them. And you know what, that's okay. You just don't have to belittle them every single time. Like literally the Bella Twins will breathe, the Bella Twins will blink, and people are just always consistently up in arms with them. If you click on any Twitter post from a major, you know, wrestling publication, if you click on a Twitter post, if you click on an Instagram post, if you click on a TikTok, there are tons and tons and tons of comments that say they suck, I never understood them, they were never... I don't get the hype, this and that. And it's like, okay, we get it. You don't like them. You don't have to repeat yourself every 6 months when something with them happens in the news. And they still defend women. They still defend women's wrestling. They do. And they cut the bullshit, honestly. You know, SummerSlam, Bianca Belair versus Becky Lynch. Nikki Bella was probably one of the first person to speak up about that whole match. And of course, you know, the match paid off, you know, towards WrestleMania and last year's SummerSlam. But she was the first person to speak out about it. And they were both one of many people, but they were one of the people, you know, that were speaking out about the treatment of the women's legends, especially when it came to the anniversary show for Monday Night Raw. So I just think that some people need to cut the shit when it comes to the Garcia twins. Like, we get it. You don't like them. No one's forcing them down your throat. And if you feel that way, maybe it's time for you to log off. That's all I got to say about that. I'm pretty sure I have so much more to say, but, you know, it's just funny. It's funny. And, you know, they respect the business and they try their best to respect the business. And they always say they know how much you guys don't like them. They know it. You know, and I can only imagine how, you know, I get the brunt of some of that sometimes, just being a woman in, you know, wrestling media. And I think a lot of women in wrestling media feel that way as well. But with the Garcia twins, I can't imagine what the hate is like for them. And it's just funny because there are a lot of male wrestlers that are horrible wrestlers, don't know anything about the business, didn't care to learn anything about the business while they were there, never grew up as wrestling fans, and only went into the business for money. Those are five things that are so accepted from wrestling fans when it comes to male wrestlers. And yet when female wrestlers, if that's the case, they are just pitchforks all the time. People get so angry about that when it comes to women, but fully accept it when it comes to men during these shoot interviews. So really funny how that works. But yeah, you know, shout out to the Garcia twins. You know, they left WWE, they changed their name, and they're getting that residual check when it comes to the 2K games. So I couldn't be proud of them as a new Bella Twins fan or Garcia Twins fan. And you know what? I do hope they go to AEW. I do hope they go to AEW, because you know how many people would be pissed off at it If they go to AEW, listen, if the Garcia twins go to AEW, I would be so happy. I would look like the meme of the little girl standing in front of a burning house and looking into the camera with an evil grin. That is me. And the burning house is the reaction that the Garcia twins will receive from the IWC. So I hope it happens because it's going to piss so many people off. And I want to see wrestling Twitter burn to the ground. So we'll see what happens there. Another great news when it comes to the WWE world, the great Muta. The great Muta will be inducted into the Hall of Fame this year. Of course, we've got Rey Mysterio. I believe Rey Mysterio is headlining this year's WrestleMania. But it's really great to see the great Muta gain this recognition. You know, I think that a lot of people were sort of against Muta being inducted into the Hall of Fame just simply because he has never wrestled in WWE. However, if you want to include WCW within the WWE umbrella, it technically counts, I guess, if you do want to count it with his run in WCW. However, if you don't want to count that, you should consider the New Japan and WWE Championship Series that happened in Japan in, I believe it was 1985. So he's had somewhat of a, you know, missed connection or a little bit of a connection with WWE. And you can't deny that he has impacted the industry. He has influenced so many wrestlers. He is a big deal. And although he has never been really affiliated with WWE, it's great to see WWE acknowledge him. And, you know, the words of the tweet was a little weird. I think a lot of people were really hinting at there is an inclusion. He's not going to be fully inducted, but he's going to be included. I don't know what that entails. However, I am excited to see him get this recognition, at least from this major company. You know, they did lend out Shinsuke Nakamura for the New Year's Day event that Noah had with Muta. And he did recently just have his retirement match. So it's really cool that he's getting that recognition. I would love to hear from you guys, especially if you're watching this on YouTube. Comment below. Who do you think should induct the great Muta into the Hall of Fame? I definitely think it should be Chono. It should be Chono. That was a tear-jerk moment during his retirement match last month when Chono came out. So I think that is the person that should induct the great Muta into the Hall of Fame. However, I think for the WWE stake standpoint of having someone who is more recognizable in the WWE universe, I think they will possibly have Ric Flair induct the great Muta. I think that he made the announcement on the bump. I wouldn't like that at all. If Sting wasn't with AEW, I would love if it was Sting. If it's Ric Flair, it is what it is. But I would love if it was either Chono or Sting inducting the great Muta into the Hall of Fame. So shout out to the great Muta. I have a special place in my heart for Muta, and I have cosplayed as Muta. I will throw the picture up now if you're watching this on YouTube. And if you're listening to this on the podcast, you can check out my socials for that photo. But yeah, really exciting stuff. Really looking forward to the Hall of Fame. I might be there at WrestleMania. I will be at WrestleMania. I will be in LA in 2 weeks. Really looking forward to WrestleMania. Really looking forward to seeing all of you guys. Seeing all of you guys, seeing the congregation from Church of Joshi, seeing so many people that I have worked with virtually online. And some of us have never really met in person before. So really looking forward to that. And like I said in the beginning of the show, I have so much fun content for y'all. And I can't wait. Can't wait to be down there. But yeah, this is it, y'all. We have 2 more weeks till WrestleMania. What is happening with the Bloodline? What is happening with Cody Rhodes? I think some people are still in a toss-up as to whether or not we should have Sammy in this feud with Cody and Roman. We're just going to have to wait and see, y'all. But I'm excited about WrestleMania. And I think it's going to be a good show. This main event is very unpredictable with Cody and Roman Reigns. I'm assuming that they're going to main event night two, possibly. And I think this is very unpredictable because either way, you know, when if you have Roman retain, he's retaining with, you know, an extraordinary run as champion. It is a legendary run. This is the best he's ever been. And this past 2 years, this is the best that he's ever been in this company. This is his best in ring work. This is his best character work. And he's working so well with so many different people. It also helps that he's working with his family. And I think in the beginning, when Paul Heyman decided to join Roman Reigns, it came as a shock for me. I was like, what the hell is going on? But they've been conquering. And along the way, Sami Zayn has helped. But Cody Rhodes won the Royal Rumble and he's going on to face Roman Reigns. So, and you know, if Cody wins, it's also good for the company. You have a brand new wrestler. You can, you know, have a fresh start with the roster. It'll be interesting to see who they would have pin against Cody with a feud with the championship. Will it be Seth Rollins? I think that would be fun to run back. However, I think that would be much fun to run back later down the line, possibly this year. But who knows? Let me know, you know, in the comments below, especially on Twitter, if you want to tweet at me, if you're listening to this audio, let me know who you would want to see face Cody if he wins the championship. What's going to lead into WWE Backlash? What's going to lead into SummerSlam? So it'll be exciting to see. It's WrestleMania season, baby. We are so close. We are so close to the showcase of the Immortals. And I absolutely cannot wait. And like I said before, I cannot wait to meet all of you. And once again, I want to thank you guys so much for understanding that this was a difficult week for me to set up a guest in a podcast. Like I said, I am a normal human being. All of us content creators in wrestling media are normal human beings, and we're all trying our best. And I am definitely trying my best. It's the best that I can do. And I'm trying my best while running a podcast, getting ready for things for WrestleMania, and getting ready to see all of you guys in LA for WrestleMania. But yeah, I just want to thank you guys for watching this. Thank you guys for listening. Let me know what you guys think of this. Tweet at me. Like I said, leave a comment down below on the YouTube channel. Let me know if you enjoy this format of a podcast. And yeah, I can't wait to hear from you guys. And again, thank you so much. I'm Alex Lajas for Queen of the Ring podcast. Do I have a closer for this? I don't, but I hope you guys enjoy this podcast episode.